What is up, everybody? Welcome back to Fallout 76. And what am I bringing you this time? I'm bringing you another build. I'm bringing you kind of what I promised you last time, which was the saloon. And I'm calling it the Lakeside Saloon because we're building here at Lakeside Cabins. Now, if you don't know where this is, we used to be here under the bridge. All you got to do is a quick hop, skip, and a jump. I almost didn't say that. Over here to literally the Lakeside Cabins. It is by a lakeside, even though it looks more like a ravine to me. But yes, we're building here now, and you can actually come visit me. But with any good building, and with any good relationship, you need one thing, and that is a foundation. I have gone for this style of foundation. Once again, I'm using my laminated floors and these kind of weird things. But it's just a simple 2x3 build for the inside. And then on the outside, there's just a nice little footpath that goes down to a little overhang that checks over the lake. And I actually really... I think this is the best build I've ever done, including my Fallout 4 builds. But with every good foundation, you need obviously four walls, because you can't just live on a floor alone. And this is kind of the style I went for. It's the crappy wooden walls that you get from the beginning of the game. But this does change. It looks kind of weird, right? It looks like a creepy place that you disappear into and no one will ever see you again. But I do change up the plan a little bit later on, because the way I had to do the second floor was just really difficult to fit in the stairs. But I did manage to go down here and obviously build my little lakeside view, as I'm calling it. And I do change this up as well. I just realized I changed a lot about this build. It's really, really weird. But the reason I love this place is because of this view right here. Now, over there is I can't remember the name of the town, but it's full of super mutants, so you can mine it. And sometimes you bump into deathclaws in this lake. So it is a really fun place to go. But if we head on inside and completely and utterly just wipe past the fact that I had a floor with a metal staircase on it there to do some recording, you can see that I've gone for the laminate floor on the inside. And back here, I did something I really, really found funny in my eyes, was I hid my camp and my stash box in a storeroom. That is literally the only point to this room, is a stash and my camp, because in other builds I've done, I've put my camp down, built on top of my camp, or put my camp in a bush, and I've never been able to access it again. So yeah, I had to find a place to do it. But the upstairs is actually really interesting. I do want people to come to this, by the way. So I built rooms, 3 rooms to be exact, and a balcony, because sleeping in game does actually have a thing. So I thought I will build something where you can actually come along and you can sleep in it. Now, this is the final design. Before I went in and fiddled with all the pretty stuff, like putting in my decorations and stuff. And I built in a back entrance, because if you are being chased by a deathclaw, you could possibly die trying to get in. So you'd have to run around the front. So I put in a back entrance, which makes it a lot easier. And then on the inside and on the outside, I changed it up a little bit again. I put those pillars in. There's pillars in that hold up because there is an overhang. I put in pillars because pillars make sense in a, you know, structural way. They are a support. But upstairs, you get a really good view. Now, I didn't show you the room. I just showed you the fact that it was, you know, a square. So what I wanted to show you was the view that you get itself from the room, which is this. It's not the best window, I admit, it's not the best window, but the view itself is actually pretty funny. Now, I actually ended up on a server where that little lake pond puddle thing you saw, someone had a base there, and we've gone into a weird war. Speaking of weird, there's also this weird glitch that I found. I actually found 2 glitches doing this. So there's this weird kind of, I was trying to, you know, put wiring around the outside to make the lights work. And I bumped into this weird glitch where it was only if you looked in a specific angle directly upwards, it'd bug out. And there was also this wiring glitch, which I didn't know about, which was that. It's really weird. I thought, oh, I've fucked up somehow. Like, the server's disconnected or whatever. But then when I hooked up this wire, worked perfectly. It was really weird. It kind of annoyed me because I had to delete some of the wires and all this other kind of stuff. Yeah, it was really annoying. But as you can see over there, there is the town just across the bridge, and with everything you need to put defenses in, because seriously, I got attacked by super mutants, scorched, mole rats, everything was fucking turning up to try and kill me, but I had to put down turrets, and then I went in and decorated everything, and I did that really simple out the back. There's a basketball hoop, which you saw when I was probably trying to connect the wiring, and then there's just that little grill, and a chair and a table, just in case you want to enjoy the view. I'd spend a lot of the time just sat here. Well, not a lot of the time, but I spend a bit of time just sat here doing absolutely nothing. And as you can see as well, I put my spotlights up. My spotlights are a fun little blueprint that I came across, but on the inside is where it really flourishes. So I had to make room for all of as many of the crafting tables as I could. So I've got my weapons, armor, and chemistry, because they're really good. And then behind the counter, and I'm doing counter in air quotes, which, you know, I can stand behind and be like, hi, what would you like today in my really ugly looking outfit? Jesus Christ, that's terrible. But there's also a cooking stove back here in case you want to do some food. I put some tables and chairs in as well, because it's a saloon, you know, you're supposed to sit down, drink, eat, be merry, all that kind of stuff. And I, as you can see, nothing else went into this room. I was thinking about doing other stuff, but I didn't have any, like, shelves or anything. So that stayed the same. And I'm using a fusion generator, which is probably really stupid, because it's 100 power for something that probably takes 8, maybe a bit more. But obviously, you know, you've just got to do what you can with the stuff you've got. And the rooms themselves were bare as hell. So the room itself, well, the landing is bare as well. There's only that, but the room itself is just a bed, a side stand with a plant on it, and a shelf. That's really it. There's no way of putting down junk decorations, which is something people are wanting, and I really want as well. And I love the shutters on this, man. I really do. It's a really Western kind of style theme. But all the rooms are the same, by the way. The only thing that changes is the plant. But yeah, junk decorations is something I'd love, because I've got a lot of good junk that I could put down and really make this thing awesome. Like, you know, Nuka-Colas, and there's that glitch again, by the way. But yeah, junk decorations is something I really want in this game, man. It's fucking... give me junk decorations. Ugh, geez. And there's that wiring glitch again. Seriously, I don't get it. It really bugs me out that some of the glitches in the building, because building's one thing I've always loved about Fallout 4, and now Fallout 76, I do love it in this as well, but the building glitches, like disappearing walls, kind of spoils it a little bit. But I don't know. But, you know, if you are ever on the on a server that I'm on, and I'm on PS4, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, I'm right here on the main road itself, as you can see. It's seriously, the main road is a really good place to build stuff, because I found people walking up and down this all the time. So that's the build, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you do stop on by, because this is, I think, my favorite build to date. So if you're ever walking down the main road, if you're ever just wandering about, don't hesitate to come on in. I am a friendly guy. I will give you some free stuff. I cook up food all the time, which I, you know, don't need. And it's, you know, it's there for you. So thanks for coming along. You know the drill. Like, share, and subscribe. And as always, stay awesome.